one comes to the Father but by me. You might think that if you won a lottery ticket today, if I gave you six numbers that said you were going to win, I might get a hug off a few of you. You might be ecstatic. Some of you might not want that. But do you know what? It's temporal. It doesn't last. Everything that's good for us ends up hurting us. Relationships outside of marriage. Doing things our way, taking drugs, having excessive alcohol. It's good for a while, but it doesn't last. Jesus Christ wants to give you a joy and a peace that you've never had in your life. And I said before, and I'm going to say it again, you can receive that peace and joy in your life today. Bless you. Bless you. So, Jesus said that you need to be born again. What does he mean by that, being born again? You can't be born a second time into your mother's womb. But what he's saying is, you can be born again. You can accept the Spirit of Christ and turn away from your past and that will you, and have that reconciliation through the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Paul says in Romans 10:9 that if you confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. So I'm here to tell you today, what mad person wouldn't want a free gift of salvation? What mad person wouldn't want eternity, to know of your eternity with Jesus Christ for what he did on the cross? There are many of you walking up and down this road that will never experience the love of God because you're more interested in what you could get out of the next 3 months of your life. I'm sorry for sounding like that, but it's true. And one day, we're all going to be in the same situation. It says that every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. You're going to be judged. And if you're going to be judged by what you've done, you're on the way to hell. I can't lie to you. God is love, but guess what? We're not. We've all broken God's commandment and he is a judge. But Jesus Christ came along 2,000 years ago and he took every rotten, stinking, filthy sin that you've ever done and ever could do and he bore it on the cross. Do you know what? When he was in the garden before he died, he said to his Father, if it be your will, take this cup away from me. What he meant by that was, he'd been in communion with the Father for eternity and he realized that God was going to turn his back on him. And this cup that he looked at carried all the filthy, rotten, stinking sins that you've ever done. And do you know what happened? It said that he sweated drops of blood. The actual medical term is called hemodidrosis. It's a scientific fact that people, with soldiers going to war, and that feared, and that in that much stress, that it says that blood raises to the surface. And that's what Jesus went through. He knew he was going to die for you, but he chose to climb on that cross because he loves you. What fool would not accept his grace and mercy? You have the opportunity to say, do you know what? I don't understand it all, but I'm going to put my trust in God, and I'm going to get to know this person who died for me on the cross. You can have that opportunity right now. I don't want to embarrass any of you, but if there's anybody here that says, do you know what? You've spoken to me today. There's something that's a burden in my heart, and what you've said is ringing true. Come around us. We're here to help you. We believe in a God that's not dead,